programme is one I am personally extremely proud of. It is 2,500 or so alumni of the highest order. It is a very good example of what we call the living bridge, that bridge that links the UK and India. How does this cyber aspect fit into the broader work of the High Commission? Well, it is an integral part of what we call the Defence and International Security Partnership, which was signed in November 2015 when Prime Minister Modi visited London.
The Chevening programme has helped us to come together or do this energy. It's going to be a really very useful, beneficial for both the countries, whether we India or the UK. And these scholars who have undergone this fellowship, they are going to be brand ambassador for both the countries to bring the understanding and the synergy more closer between the two countries.
When a common man loses money because of using mWallet or digital wallet, you need to address his grievance. If you don't address his grievance, then he is a dissatisfied guy. So he's bad for us. So we need to address this via having ODR. ODR is online dispute resolution mechanism. You can have one single menu in your app itself, and you can resolve the dispute online itself.
From the government point of view, the Central Board of Direct Taxes is promoting voluntary compliance. It has brought out new incentives for people to pay tax in the form of that if there are the digital taxations are taxed at a lesser rate. It was recently brought in the new budget. Thirdly, with coming of GST, with more third-party information flowing in, so all this, people are coming into the formal economy and people will start paying more taxes.
The panel discussion was quite insightful and the level of technical experts that we had in the session was great. It gave me an insight on the ground realities or the challenges that we are facing today in securing a digital India. And obviously we focus on a few of the solutions, and with India and UK both being strategic partners in cybersecurity, I think this kind of discussions will further benefit both the countries.
It had been a very interesting experience in the sense that, you know, it gave us a great opportunity to look around what's going on in UK, how they have been able to centralize the entire decision making around cyber.
I must thank Cranfield on this, you know, the kind of efforts they put in making the program meaningful and successful for the participants as well as for Chevening to keep up the reputation.